Hiwatt X, one of my personal favorites and incredibly underrated. 1966, 3 years after Marshall released its first amp, Hiwatt was started by a lone enthusiast who was repairing and building amps in his garage. His name was Dave Reeves. His amps were built like tanks and sounded like them too. At first, Reeves just built a few custom amps for local bands. Then Sound City, which was owned by Arbiter, a major UK distributor and music store retailer who ended up making the Fuzz face, hired Reeves to build amps under the name Hiwatt. Once Vox started to lose its footing as a major player in the early 70s, Hiwatt became the only significant competitor to Marshall in the UK. Pete Townsend, who was a major poster boy of Marshall, began sporting Hiwatt amps. David Gilmour bought every member of Pink Floyd a half-stack Hiwatt 100. Led Zeppelin rotated four or five brands of amps, Hiwatt included. Jethro Tull, the Moody Blues, and Rush all used Hiwatt as well. So why are they so good? They were built to very high standards. Military-grade attention to detail, with perfect right angles on wiring and components. The circuits included ample filtering and high-quality transformers. They sound bold with plenty of headroom and bottom end. They were especially great platforms for a pedal-based rig. Although Hiwatts were among the first to feature an output master volume knob, the preamps are not high gain, so the amps don't produce much distortion at low volume. They need to be cranked up before they produce overdrive, but because they provide an impressive amount of clean headroom, it's advisable to protect your ears. I mean, just ask Pete Townsend, who is legally deaf. Whereas Dick Dale demanded Fender to upgrade their 50-watt amps to 100 watts, and Pete Townsend did the same with Marshall, Hiwatt provided the world with 50 watts, 100 watts, 200 watts, and f*** it, 400 watt amps, and said, here you go, just in case you ever needed more than more. Ride like the wind, bullseye. Hiwatt was doing insanely well until 1981, when Dave Reeves suddenly passed away. The company continued and even added some new models, but soon failed. The Hiwatt name was sold off, and a UK entity reissues the original models and offers some new ones as well. I'm currently saving up for a white Hiwatt 50 as we speak. So yeah, tell your friends so I can make some goddamn money from these videos, will you? Alright, thanks.